Hello, my name is Pepe Lam, and today I'll be talking about Spectrum Sentinel. Spectrum Sentinel is an offering that consists of two components. One is the orchestration engine, which is using Spectrum Copy Data Management, and the second is the anomaly scan engine. Spectrum Copy Data Management is a simple deploy VM that you can deploy using an OVA file in your vCenter environment. After deploying the VM, you will log in, and this will be the first screen that you'll see, which is the CDM dashboard. The dashboard will give you information on your appliance, such as the job status, statistics on all the different jobs that have run, and if you have any reports, it will list out all the reports. Now, one of the first things we want to do is configure the appliance. So first, you want to navigate over to the Configure tab. And here, you have a list of all your providers. Your providers are your application servers, your storages, your anomaly scan servers, and if you're using a virtual environment, your vCenter. Now, first thing we want to do is register your storage. So I already have my storage registered, but I want to go through the process to show how simple it is to register the storage and the different providers. So you want to right-click on IBM Spectrum Virtualize, hit register. And here on this screen, first thing you'll notice is the drop-down for a different site. Then the next text field is the name, which is a logical name that you can provide. After that is the host address, which could be a fully qualified domain name or IP address. And the last thing you want to do is provide user credentials. You can select user credentials from a list of existing user credentials that are saved in your CDM appliance. Or you can actually create new user credentials by providing new username and password. Next thing we want to register, if you have a virtual environment, you want to register the vCenter. I already have one here, but the registration is pretty simple. You want to just right click and register, and it's the same screen as the storage. Site, name, host address, and credentials. Now, the next thing I want to register is your application. So you want to click on the application server. And you'll see here, I have two application servers, but I want to show the simplicity of registering the application server. So right click on application server, hit register. And here are all the different applications that CDM supports. It supports SAP HANA, SQL, Oracle, and InterSystems databases, which is including Cache and Iris. Now, Spectrum Sentinel with scanning is only available for InterSystem databases, such as Cache or Iris. So we're going to select InterSystems database, and it's going to be a similar registration screen where we have a site, name, host address, and here you have the option of a virtual appliance application server or physical. If you select virtual, you just have to make sure you select the vCenter. You also have the OS type, which is a dropdown for Cache or Iris, can be both AIX or Linux. Now, for Spectrum Sentinel, for this first release, only Linux OS is available for scanning for Cache and Iris. AIX is something that will be added in a future release of Spectrum Sentinel. After that, you just have to provide user credentials, which you can select from a dropdown, or provide or register new user credentials. Now, next thing we want to register is the security scan server or the anomaly scan engine. So here I already have my anomaly scan engine, but I want to go into details on how to actually register. So you want to right click on it, hit register. And once again, the registration screen is similar to what you've seen before. You have site, name, host address. Now, one thing I do want to note, we have a type, virtual or physical. So here I want to actually bring your attention over to the slide deck so we can go over the differences between virtual and physical. Now, for virtual anomaly scan servers, it will support both virtual and physical applications. For physical anomaly scan servers, it will support only physical. Meaning that if you have a Cache or Iris database that is running on physical hardware, you can only utilize a physical scan server. And now I want to bring your attention back to the demo And after picking the specific type, then you want to just provide user credentials for the API and the system credentials. The next section I want to highlight is the access control. So you want to navigate over to access control. And here, this is where you'll create user accounts and you'll grant access to different resources or roles. So first you can create the user account, and the resource pool is what users have access to. And for the roles tab, we'll define what roles they have for that user account. Next section I want to highlight is the identities. And here I'll list out all the user credentials that are saved in your SCDM appliance. Next, we want to navigate to SLA policies, and this is where you'll be creating the SLA policies that define the frequency and the retention of your backups. So first, we want to hit the new link, select IBM Spectrum Virtualize, and here you'll first set the frequency of your backup. You can set it minutes, hourly, daily, weekly, or monthly. Next, we want to select the backup type. For Spectrum Sentinel, you must select the safeguarded copy backup type. Now, I want to actually direct your attention to the slide so I can go into more details about the prerequisites for safeguarded copy. Now, there are some additional prerequisites before you configure safeguarded copy SLA policy in Spectrum Copy Data Management. On your IBM Flash System storage, you must ensure that any volume that you plan to protect is in a volume group. Second, you also want to ensure that that volume group is set to an external scheduling policy. Now, those are the two prerequisites that you must complete before you configure the SLA policy in Spectrum Copy Data Management. Now, I want to redirect you back to the demo. Now, from this screen, you want to select the volume group. And this will be the volume group that CDM will be protecting during the backup job. Next, you want to set the retention. Now, the retention here will be sent over to the storage, and the IBM storage will then manage the retention for any safeguarded copy that gets created. SCDM will not delete any of the safeguarded copies. The deletion of the safeguarded copies will be by the IBM storage system. You can add a volume prefix for the safeguarded copy. And this new feature for Spectrum Sentinel is you want to make sure perform security scan is checked, and then you can select which backup you want to run the scan on. By default, it will run on every backup, but you can change it, that value, to which backup you want it to run on. After that, you want to make sure you select the security scan service. Now, that completes the configuration of Spectrum Copy Data Management for Spectrum Sentinel. Next, I want to navigate over you to the Jobs tab to start the process of creating a backup job and a restore job. Now, this job section lists out all the jobs in your CDM appliance. If you want to first create a backup job for Spectrum Sentinel, you want to make sure you select InterSystems Database, navigate over to the new button, select Backup, and here you want to select the cache instance on the left-hand side. After that, you want to select the SLA policy. And then you want to make sure you enable the schedule by navigating over to the schedule time, hitting the none, and making sure enable schedule is checked, and then setting the time that you want your backup to run. Now, once you provide a name, then you can hit the create job button, and then your job will be created. And now we'll move on to how you actually start the backup job. Now from this screen, if you want to trigger the backup job, you just have to highlight it and hit the start button. Once you hit the start button, a job log link will appear on the left-hand side, the bottom. And then if you want to look at any historical jobs, you want to hit history, and then you click on the link for the job log. Now let me turn your attention over to the slide so I can go over the details of what's going on in the job log. Now, since this is using a safeguarded SLA policy with scanning enabled, what CDM is going to do during the backup job is it's first going to look for the cache or iris instance of backup, it's going to collect information on where the database data exists on which disk, map it to the storage volume. Once it's mapped to the storage volume, it will then check to see that if the volume is in a volume group. Once it's confirmed that the volume is in a volume group and it matches the volume group in the SLA policy, CDM will then tell the storage to create a flash copy within the safeguarded child pool. Once it creates the flash copy in the safeguarded child pool, it will complete the backup portion of the job and then move on to the scanning portion. Now, the scanning portion, what CDM is going to do is it's going to take the safeguarded copy that was just created, clone a new volume, and then it's going to mount that volume to the anomaly scan engine. Once it's mounted the volumes to the anomaly scan engine, CDM will then run API calls to notify the scanning engine to scan that specific volume for any changes to the backup. Once the anomaly scan engine has completed analyzing the backup, then it'll notify CDM of the results of its scan. CDM will then take the message from the anomaly scan engine and display it in the job log. Now I'll navigate you back to the demo so you can see an example of the message in the job log from the anomaly scan engine. As you can see in this job log, the anomaly scan engine has detected a threat and now the CDM has displayed it as a failed job. Now, CDM will also display all the historical records of previous backup job runs. So it'll make sure that it'll show the status of the anomaly scan, and it will also show the message from the anomaly scan. If a backup was a clean backup, it will state that no threat has been detected. But if a threat has been detected, then it'll state it in the message column, and it'll change the status of the job to failed. Next, we want to move on to the creation of a restore job. So you want to go to new, hit restore. And here you have two different types for your restore. You have the instant disk restore and instant database restore. Instant disk restore will go through the process of looking for the restore point, cloning a volume, mounting it to the target system. Instant database does the exact same thing as instant disk, but will also run cache or iris commands to bring up the instance. So here we're going to select instant database restore. Then you want to select the cache instance that was just protected. Navigate over to the copy section. And here you want to select the button that's to select specific version or use latest successful scan. Here you have three different options. You can use the latest scan, you could use the latest successful scan, or if you want to look for specific restores to restore from, you can select under the version column and it'll bring up this menu of which restore point you want to restore. Now, this screen will show which backups are safeguarded copies and will also show the status of the anomaly scans. So you'll see here that there are some backups that I've had that are clean scans and then some that were threat has been detected. Now, if you select the backup that has a threat detected, there will be a pop-up that will be displayed that you will have to confirm that you're going to run a restore of a backup that has a potential ransomware. So now we want to hit the yes button because I want to utilize this backup that has ransomware. Then navigate over to destination. Now under the destination, this is where you're going to be restoring the cache or iris database to. You can either restore it to a secondary target server, or you can restore it back to itself. Once you provide a name, then you can hit the create job button and that'll create your restore job. So now if you want to start the restore job, you want to make sure it's highlighted and then you can hit the start button. And you want to hit yes. And then this started the restore job and you'll see a job log link has been created. And if you click on that link, it will go into details on what's happening in the restore job. Now, I want to navigate your attention over to the slide. And here, this is where I'm going to describe what steps CDM is taking for the restore job. First, since this is an instant database restore, CDM is going to restore the cache instance. First, what CDM is going to do is look for the restore point that was selected. Then once it finds that restore point, it's going to look for the safeguarded copy of that restore point. From that safeguarded copy, it's going to clone a new volume. And once that new volume has been created, it's going to mount it to the target system. Once it mounts it to the target system, CDM then will then communicate with the target system and run specific commands to mount the disk, and then also run cache commands to bring up the instance. And now I want to navigate your attention back to the demo. And as you can see here, the restore job has completed. And if you close the job log link, you will notice that your restore job is now in a resource active state. If you navigate down to the job log link and if you right click on it, now this restore has two different options. You can do a cancel restore, which will gracefully clean up the copy that was just created. Or you can also run the option to make permanent, which will transition this test copy to a permanent copy. Now, today I'm going to be selecting cancel restore, which will gracefully clean up the restore on the target system. Now that concludes the demonstration of Spectrum Sentinel. Please reference this slide for my contact information if you have any questions.